idea. It's something that affects us all, even though it's something that we may not see outright or maybe something that we just ignore. Here to talk about feminism and the media is Brooke Leonard.
Now, there are many misconceptions about feminism, so I want to clear this up right off the bat. Feminism is a theory of the political, economic, and social equality of the sexes, according to Merriam-Webster. Or, if you prefer to consult Urban Dictionary, a feminist is someone who believes the radical notion that women are people. Now, I found that the most common reaction to feminism is fear. People are so afraid of being thought of as a bad feminist or a feminazi that they pretend it's not a problem. But it is. A few years ago, I was talking with my friends at the lunch table, and somehow the word feminism was brought up. Now, I didn't think anything of it. I thought the definition of feminism was pretty clear. So I was pretty surprised when I found that many of my friends grimaced at the word and like just protested calling themselves feminists, even when they knew, finally learned that it just meant that you believe that people should be equal. Now, that's why I'm here today. I want to show you how one word can change the world for the better. And we need feminism because despite the ground covered in schools, at the workplace, and at home, we still need feminism in a place that affects us more than anywhere else, the media. Now, I want you to picture in your mind a strong, empowered female character. Most likely, the woman you're envisioning looks something like this. Now, what do all these women have in common? They're ruthless, unapologetic. Most of them have to display some act of violence in order to show their power. Take, for example, Katniss Everdeen from The Hunger Games. She's just some nobody from District 12 until everyone finds out that she goes a bow and arrow and has a major attitude. There is absolutely nothing wrong with a woman acting masculine, but if it's her only vehicle to power, that's when it becomes a problem. Now, don't get me wrong, there are some this also got me kind of thinking about women in politics. Worldwide, we are ranked 100th for female representation in government. There's only 196 countries in the entire world, and we're worse than 99 of them. Why is this? Is it because the media, or you can only point to like a woman's nail color or how low cut her pantsuit is? Is it because the media tells us that politics is just another man's job? Now, a very popular phrase among many media professionals is, we give the people what they want. Now, this isn't entirely true. The media tells us what we want, and we listen. Let me give you an example. So, a study conducted by Ray Baumeister showed, he took a group of men and women and showed them a sexually stimulating video of a man and a woman. Now, not surprisingly, most of the men in the study were more attracted to the woman in the video. However, nearly every single woman was equally attracted to the man and the video and the woman, in the video. Now, the women in the study weren't all lying about their sexuality. They were just trained to see the woman through the perspective of a man. This is called the male gaze. Now, most media content is geared toward this male gaze, and it's become so common that women have adopted it too. This is kind of a huge problem. Women should be seen as something more than just a sexual object, and women should see other women as something more than just a sexual object. Okay, so now you may be thinking, okay, well, how do I know if the movie I'm watching has a fair representation of women and all that? Well, there's a handy little test that you can use. That's why I keep bringing them together. there's a handy little test that you can use called the Bechdel test, created by Alison Bechdel. And this has three easy steps. There's three easy steps to this test, so follow along if you'd like. All right. Step one. Does the movie you love, are there multiple female characters in the movie? Thinking of it? Okay. Is there a scene where these two female characters in your favorite movie, if you're following along, is there a scene where they actually talk to each other? Do they interact with words, you know? Step three, do they talk about something other than a boy? Now, you'd be amazed to find that most movies do not pass the Bechdel test. Finding Nemo, failed. Back to the Future, failed. The original Star Wars trilogy, The Great Gatsby, The Avengers, Jaws, The Lion King, The Little Mermaid, 7 out of 8 Harry Potter movies failed the Bechdel test. You heard that right. Only Deathly Hallows Part 1 passed, and the only scene where women were interacting was when Bellatrix was torturing Hermione, so I don't think that's a very good example of girl power. Now, we can't forget that we actually have come a long way. Yes, there's still derogatory music and movies out there, but now with social media becoming a huge part of everyday life, women are able to share their ideas and the injustices they've experienced in a way they've never have been able to before. And media professionals are able to see how they can better represent women in their content. So, you might be thinking, well, what if I was kind of against feminism before today, or I don't know, just the word itself, so intimidating, it's aggressive. Well, it's not. All feminism is admitting to yourself that what you're listening to or what you're watching objectifies over half of the world's population. So right now we're living in the age of third wave feminism. The first wave being the fight for women's suffrage, and the second wave being the fight for equality in the workplace and at home and in schools. Now these are still very relevant issues today, especially today. But what makes third wave feminism different is that it relies on our individual choices as opposed to government intervention. Now, changing what we do and say and watch isn't going to stop all gender-based violence and close the wage gap and end all gender discrimination, but it's a start. So don't be afraid to use the word feminism. The more we are afraid of a word, the less we want